broadcasting from the basement of La Penta. It's WICR.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the Sports Vault Jersey. Joe Arcino back here. And heroics always create excitement, and there was no shortage of heroics in the UEFA Champions League yesterday. And of course, the heroes of the day for their respective clubs, Kevin De Bruyne for Manchester City, putting Manchester City in the semifinals for the first time in the club's history. And then Cristiano Ronaldo with his 3 goals for Real Madrid, bringing them back from the depths to defeat Wolfsburg. And It's really an example of what makes the sport so special and what makes that competition the ultimate just example of sport across the world. The UEFA Champions League, I mean, I think from an individual competition standpoint, is the most exciting thing in the world. There's nothing that comes close to the pure noise and the pure just energy when the players walk out of the tunnel, and when you hear the UEFA Champions League theme music playing from orchestras, it's really something that you just have to sit there and not think and just listen. The sounds tell you all about why this competition is so special. And of course, the matches yesterday did not disappoint one bit. And it's what it comes down to. Manchester City is really an example of, they have not lived up to their end of the deal in their individual league. Their Premier League season has been a massive disappointment because they've just shown an inability to defeat the top clubs. I mean, you talk about Leicester City Football Club, they haven't been able to beat them. You talk about clubs like Arsenal, clubs like Tottenham, they just can't get it done against them. And that is extremely surprising and disappointing to the Man City faithful, because this is a star-studded cast of players. On paper, probably the best club in the English Premier League, but they have not been able to get it done there. But where they have had their success this season has been in the biggest competition of all, and Kevin De Bruyne sealing their victory over Paris Saint-Germain. And I did not think City was going to be able to beat PSG coming into this one, but I was proved wrong. And of course, as soon as they had that level 2-2, walking away from PSG, and they got to go back to the Etihad, I think instantly everyone changed their mind, because as long as City could get it level and then go back home, they had a massive advantage. And of course, PSG was missing some key players, Man City missing their captain Vincent Kompany, as they have been for most of the season. But Kevin De Bruyne has been the solid rock for Man City's season. In an overall season defined by inconsistency, he has been the most consistent part of the equation. And then he's served some time being injured as well, but he comes back, makes an instant impact, and he puts Man City in a position they have never been in before. And then Cristiano Ronaldo, of course. It has been a very tough season for Real Madrid. They've gotten back a little bit, and right now they're playing tremendously. They're really playing their best of the season. I mean, they defeat Barcelona at the Camp Nou, disrupt their 39-match unbeaten streak. Then they have that disappointing loss to Wolfsburg in the Champions League. They kind of pick up some more steam as Barcelona loses again this past weekend. They're really only back a little bit now. I still don't think Barcelona is going to concede anything, but they're certainly playing and they're in a better position than they have been in a long while. And it just comes down to Cristiano Ronaldo. And last season, I was disappointed because in the final four in the semifinals of the Champions League last year against Juventus, Ronaldo really was absent. He just was. You watch the second leg that they played against each other, I'm not sure if I've ever seen Ronaldo as invisible as he was. And for a player of that caliber to look as absent as he did again in a game of that magnitude, it just doesn't sit right. But in that game against Wolfsburg, he taps back into his greatness and shows us all why he is at the level he is. I always like to compare the way world soccer is to the NBA, kind of comparing LeBron to Messi, and then maybe we'll go back to vintage Kobe to a guy like Ronaldo. But it's even above that. It really is like you've got Messi, it's really like Jordan and then LeBron going up against each other in the same prime of their careers, and we just continue to see the glimpses. Now, there's always that age-old debate between who's better, Ronaldo and Messi. They're different, so it's you're never going to have a surefire answer. I do go with Messi just based on the multitude of different ways that he can beat you. But I think it's always a fun debate to have. And certainly today, now the kind of the scenario, it flips to Messi because he's had a little bit of a scoring drought. Barcelona has shown a little bit of vulnerability, losing their last two games in La Liga. They snuck away and found a way to win in their last Champions League game against Atletico Madrid. But now they travel and they play Atletico Madrid on the road. They're away from the Camp Nou. It's a difficult game. It's filled with some difficult circumstances, but it's kind of like it was for Ronaldo yesterday in Real Madrid. They are desperate. They're backed up into a wall, and the best player on the pitch delivers and shows why he's so special. And I think it's kind of the writing is now on the walls today for Messi to do the same thing for Barcelona. And really, these last set of Champions League games have been defined by one player. Real Madrid's game was defined by their best player, Ronaldo. Man City, theirs was defined by Kevin De Bruyne. And I think today you will see in Bayern Munich's final game, and you will see in Barcelona's final game, that the best players, again, define the day. Sometimes that's all you need. A lot of times collective teams will win the biggest prizes. But sometimes you're just off on your game and you need the players that you pay these exorbitant wages to and the players you depend on the most to step up. And sometimes you only need one. Ronaldo, he did it for Real Madrid. Kevin De Bruyne, he did it for Manchester City. And I think today you see Messi put some massive, massive pressure on Atletico Madrid and get it done for Barcelona. And if we kind of look at the way that the semifinals are shaping up, if you have a Bayern Munich, Barcelona, Real Madrid, Manchester City, that is a star-studded best of the best of Europe equation. I think everybody wins with that scenario. And you kind of cross what the matches could potentially be. You have could possibly have an El Clasico rematch. You could have Barcelona against Bayern Munich. I think no matter how you cut it, they're all very difficult matches for no matter who they're playing. Any of those teams could lose to any of those teams. Even Manchester City, who you'd probably consider the weakest of all of them, have the talent to beat any one of those clubs, and it's going to be a tremendous sight to watch. But yesterday's matches are defined by the best of the best, by the word heroic, Kevin De Bruyne, Cristiano Ronaldo putting on the show, and I think today you see Lionel Messi join that club and gets it done for his club in FC Barcelona. But until then, Jersey Joe Archino here with the Sports Vault. You can follow me on Twitter at Joe Archino and on Instagram, Jersey_Joe_Archino. And I'll see everybody next time.